Located on the west side of Tano Basin at the base of Mount Ord is the site of Camp Reno. Camp Reno was a small military fort operated by the U.S. Army from 1868 to 1870 in an attempt to control the Apache people of central Arizona. Unfortunately, there is little left to see at Camp Reno. A wooden sign erected by the Boy Scouts identifies the site. A few piles of sand and some faint rock foundations mark the locations of the camp's buildings. A long rock wall, which may be the remnants of the stockade that was built shortly before Camp Reno was abandoned, partially surrounds the site. Vegetation in the area is recovering from the 2005 Edge Fire. In October of 1867, soldiers from Fort McDowell began constructing a wagon road northeast into the Matazel Mountains. The road followed Sycamore Creek up to the Sunflower area, where two temporary camps known as Camp Carroll and Camp O'Connell were established. The wagon road then turned east, crested the Matazel Mountains at Reno Pass, and descended Reno Canyon to the site of another temporary fort near Reno Creek in Tano Basin. From there, the road continued up Tano Creek to a location known as Green Valley, where the permanent Camp Reno would be built. After 10 months of hard work and numerous attacks from Apaches, the wagon road was completed to Green Valley. Due to the lack of manpower, though, the Army abandoned its plan to build Camp Reno in Green Valley and declared the temporary camp on Reno Creek to be the new Camp Reno. The Army constructed barracks, officers' quarters, a bakery, and other structures, mostly out of adobe. Camp Reno served as a base for Army expeditions into the surrounding areas and as a meeting place for the soldiers and the Apache. Tano Apache leader Del Shea frequented the fort and pursued peaceful relations with the Army at times, despite having been shot by them on two separate occasions. By 1870, the Army considered Camp Reno a failure and abandoned it that spring. Its isolated location in a harsh desert environment, along with a chronic shortage of soldiers, had proven too expensive and difficult for the Army to operate. In the century and a half following Camp Reno's abandonment, the desert has reclaimed the site, and the adobe structures have succumbed to the elements, dissolving into piles of sand. An archaeological study in the early 1990s produced a map of the site and small items such as brass coat buttons and bullets. And that's a look at Camp Reno on the Tano. I'm Randy Roberson. Thanks for watching.